Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video we will see the anatomy of the respiratory system. So nurse should know the anatomy of the respiratory system in many competitive exams. So anatomy is the commonest subject they were asking, so many nurses feel difficulty in anatomy. So in this video I am trying to help you to learn something regarding the anatomy of the respiratory system. So we will start the session without any further delay. Anatomy of the respiratory system. So I think you all know what are the organs of the respiratory system. So the first organ of the respiratory system is nose, then it leads to pharynx, then it leads to larynx, then trachea, bronchi and their branches, and it finally leads to lungs. A lungs contains alveoli. So you can see in this diagrammatic representation also, the first it is nose, it is followed by pharynx, it is followed by larynx, and then trachea. Then trachea is divided into bronchi. Bronchi we have again further divide into bronchioles and smaller branches, and it ultimately forms lungs. We will see in detail regarding each thing. The first thing is nose. So nose is the only external visible part of the respiratory system. Remaining all parts are present inside of the body. So when we see nose, what we are seeing is nostrils. So during breathing, air enters the nose by passing through the nostrils. Nostrils is also called as nares. Then nasal cavity. The interior of the nose consists of the nasal cavity. This nasal cavity is divided by a midline. This midline we call it as nasal septum. So we have two nares, which is divided by nasal septum. Next, palate. The nasal cavity is separated from the oral cavity by a partition. It is called as palate. So can see in the diagram, so the nasal cavity is separated from the oral cavity by a thing called as palate. So in palate we have two types of thing is there: hard palate and soft palate. So hard palate is present at the anteriorly, which is supported by a bone, whereas followed by hard palate it is soft palate. The soft palate is unsupported posterior part. So this nasal, we can see the pharynx is divided into three parts: blue color nasopharynx, it is followed by oropharynx, and then laryngopharynx. The portions of the pharynx: air enters the superior portion, which is called as nasopharynx, from the nasal cavity. Then nasopharynx is descends through the oropharynx. Then laryngopharynx, it enters into the larynx. Pharyngotympanic tube. The pharyngotympanic tubes which drain the middle ear opens into the nasopharynx. So there is a common passage between ear and pharynx. This tube we call it as pharyngotympanic tube. Next is larynx. Larynx is also called as voice box. It routes air and food into the proper channels and play a role in speech. The larynx is the one which separates air and food. It is also helps play a role in speech production. The structure of the larynx. This is located inferior to the pharynx. It is formed by 8 rigid hyoid cartilages and a spoon-shaped flap of elastic cartilage. It is called as epiglottis. This larynx contain a spoon-shaped elastic cartilage. This is called as epiglottis. So it is composed of several irregularly shaped cartilages attached to each other by ligaments and membranes. The main cartilage, larynx consists of one thyroid cartilage, one cricoid cartilage, two arthroid cartilage and one epiglottis. Vocal cords. Epiglottis sometimes refers to as guardian of the airways. The epiglottis protects the superior opening of the larynx. It is like a flap shape. It helps to opening and closing of the vocal cords. Vocal cords. The parts of the mucous membrane of the larynx forms a pair of folds. It is called as vocal cords or true vocal cords. These vocal cords will vibrate with air and allow us to speak. Glottis. The slit-like passageway between the vocal cords is called as glottis. So you can see the diagrammatic representation, the shape of the vocal cords, how it is there when it is open, how it is there, you know, closed. Okay. Next is thyroid cartilage. The largest of the hyaline cartilage is the shield-shaped thyroid cartilage, which produces anteriorly, and this thyroid cartilage is commonly called as Adam's apple. Next, trachea. Air enters the trachea. Trachea is also called as windpipe from the larynx. Travels down into, it is about 10 to 12 centimeters or 4 inches to the 5th thoracic vertebra, which is approximately mid chest. So trachea is followed between larynx and it is present up to 5th thoracic vertebra. Structure. The trachea is fairly rigid because its the walls are reinforced with 16 to 20 incomplete C-shaped rings of hyaline cartilage. So it consists of 16 to 20 hyaline incomplete cartilages. Bronchi. The right and left bronchi are formed by the division of the trachea. This bronchus run obliquely and into the medial depression of the lung on its own side. The right main bronchus is wider and shorter and straighter than the left. So right side is wider, shorter and straighter when compared to left side. Then bronchioles. In the mediastinum at the level of 5th thoracic vertebra, the trachea is divided into right and left primary bronchi. This bronchi is again further divided into smaller and smaller passages, and it forms a sacs. These sacs we call it as alveoli. This bronchi tree is again further divided and ultimately forms a structure called as alveoli. Lungs. The lungs are the soft and spongy because they are mostly air spaces surrounded by the alveolar cells, and it is composed of elastic connective tissue. They are separated with each other by mediastinum, which contains the heart. You can see in the diagrammatic representation, two lungs are present. Between two lungs, a heart will be there. This heart is present on the left side of the lung. The only point of attachment for each lung is at the hilum or root on the medial side. Only one point it attached to the thing. It is called as hilum. Through this hilum, bronchi, blood vessels, lymphatics and nerves enters into the lung. Organization of the lungs. So we have two lungs, right lung and left lung. So right lung consists of three lobes, whereas left lung consists of two lobes. Right lung has superior lobe, middle lobe and left lobe, whereas inferior lobe. Whereas left lung consists of only two lobes, that is superior lobe and inferior lobe. The right lung is shorter, broader and greater when compared to the volume of the left lung. The right lung is divided into three lobes and each lobe is supplied by one of the secondary bronchi. Left lung is shorter, longer and narrower than the right lung. This left lung has an indentation, which is called as cardiac notch, on the middle surface for the apex of the heart. Left lung has two lobes, superior lobe and inferior lobe. Next, trachea. Air enters the trachea. Trachea is also called as windpipe. From the larynx, travels down into, it is about 10 to 12 centimeters or 4 inches to the 5th thoracic vertebra. It is approximately mid chest. So trachea is followed between larynx and it is present up to 5th thoracic vertebra. Structure. The trachea is fairly rigid because it's the wall. It contains a thin serous fluid that is produced by the pleura. This fluid acts as a lubricant and it reduces the friction as the two layers slide against each other. It helps to hold the lower two layers together as the lungs inflate and deflate. So this fluid acts as a balloon. So it protects the lung from damage. Blood supply. Pulmonary circulation. It carries deoxygenated blood away from the heart to the lungs and returns oxygenated blood back to the heart. So this pulmonary circulation carries oxygenated blood to the heart. Pulmonary circulation is the portion of the cardiovascular system that carries oxygen depleted blood to the lungs from the heart, that is deoxygenated blood from the heart to the lungs and returns oxygenated blood to the heart. Oxygenated blood leaves the lungs through pulmonary veins. So only pulmonary vein which carries oxygenated blood. Veins which carry oxygenated blood is pulmonary veins. This blood enters the left atrium and then transferred to the left ventricle, which pumps the newly oxygenated blood into systemic circulation. Then the only artery which carries deoxygenated blood is pulmonary artery. It carries deoxygenated blood to the lungs where it releases carbon dioxide and picks up the oxygen during respiration. I hope this video is somewhat helpful to you and you gain some knowledge in this video. So if you like this video, please press like, share your comments, share this video and then subscribe to my YouTube channel. So if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, you will get an icon. Please bell notification for recent updates. Thank you.